important step in preparing curved canal. And by the way, this step may take 1 hour and a half an hour for you if you are doing it in a proper way in curved canal. While the shaping procedure, it may take only a minute. So give the time for the glide path procedure. And for our attendants who doesn't know what does mean glide path, show you this video which explains glide path and the importance of this procedure. Glide path is the procedure we place small files, for example, file number 10, stainless steel, a K file. And the purpose of this procedure is how to prepare a smooth glide pathway from the orifice to the apex. This glide smooth pathway will ensure the safety of our rotary instrument to insert inside the canal to reach the apex without any risk of fracture. So we used the beginning file number 10, K file number 10 stainless steel. Our motion should be mixed between winding, filing, beaming. All the procedure, all the technique should be used, especially in curved canal, in calcified canal, narrow canal, until we reach the working length. Of course, between each insertion, we must apply more irrigants, sodium hypochlorite irrigants. I don't prefer it, and we will talk about the irrigation in the canal. After having a smooth canal, we will change from 10, file 10 to number 15 to number 20. Until we reach file 20, we considered ourselves, we finished that glide path. Now we start after we finish glide path. So now we are ready to do the shaping procedure for the canal. But before we talk about this shaping procedure, let's discuss about the irrigation. Irrigation frequently using sodium hypochlorite will help us to remove the debris, which may block the canals in case of curved canal, narrow canals. However, I don't recommend to use EDITA as this the early step or early time in shaping of the canal. Why? Because as the shielding agent or effect may soften the dentine, which may cause leaching of the canal easily. So using sodium hypochlorite will be safer compared with EDITA. And especially the sodium hypochlorite has its effect for the dissolution of the soft tissue, pulp tissue. But research and studies in 2010 approved that the irrigants does not reach the apex due to the curve of the canal, especially when we use the needle irrigation, which is and this needle does not reach or go beyond the curvature, which makes the irrigants just fill the middle of the canal, while after the curvature, there is no irrigants reach this area. And this gives the importance of this product from BD company. They announced this irrigant step before several years. It is a materials used from silicone. It's highly flexible, can take the shape of the canal. As you see in the video, this is a metal needle irrigation, which cannot go beyond the curvature and have risk fracture inside the canal, while the Airiflex tip can goes easily till the apex. It has a two-sided, double-sided vented, which can do a safe irrigation because it is blind tip designed especially for endo. So for curved canal, I highly recommended this type of irrigation tips as they allow or ensure the irrigants to reach the apex. And this is what the most important step in endo to clean or to disinfect the canal properly. So sodium hypochlorite is better than using EDITA at the beginning. We just use EDITA in this cases only in the last step as removing the smear layer before the obturation. The second step, the second procedure we should put it in our mind during preparing the cleft canal, it is the patency. I know, guys, there is an argument about the use doing a patency or not. We are damaging the dental ligament at the apex. But believe me, when you are dealing with cleft canal, the patency it is the key factors for you to reach the apex and to keep this reaching until the obturation. Otherwise, you may reach the apex in the beginning of the instrumentation. Then at the end, you will notice yourself that the canal is blocked and you cannot reach or regain the working length as the beginning. So what is the patency? The patency, it is using a stainless steel file, maybe number 8, maybe number 10 key file, at the working length plus 1 millimeter. For example, if the working length is 20, so we're going to use this file number 10 at the working length 21. Why this step we do it to ensure that the canal, the apical part of the canal, is not blocked. So okay, let me ask, what about this 1 millimeter of the file goes beyond the apex? Does this cause apical extrusion of the debrets? Does it cause pain? No. Research proved that patency will reduce the postoperative pain because the diameter of the tip of the file number 10 is so small that does not push a large amount of debris. Just push a little bit of debris that does not initiate an immune response. While if you are doing a recapitulation, which is the last, the technique we have been using, which is using the master apical file, it is the one which causes postoperative pain. Why? Because you prepare the master apical file, for example, the apex prepared it by, for example, master apical file 35. So when you are doing a step back, between each step filed, are using the master apical file as a recapitulation. This mass file, which is as a tip size similar to the apex, when it goes between file and file, reach the apex, all the debris which has been accumulated during the filing will be pushed apically due to the recapitulation file. So that file will reduce less pain, less blockage, especially in cleft canal. And this picture shows that the file 10 is so smaller than it causes pushing, it causes immune response due to pushing debris. Okay, after we discussed about the irrigation type of irrigation and the patency and the importance of patency in cleft canal, let's go to the most important part of this lecture, how to shape the canal, how we do our technique, divided the canals into zones that allow us to prepare the canal in a safe way. One of the techniques is called the zone technique. In this technique, we divide the canal into two parts, the straight part, which is called the coronal zone, and the curved part, which is called the apical part. It does not necessary to be the apical part, it's the apical third. No. Maybe the apical part, the whole canal except the coronal third, if it is the only straight part. So the apical part and the coronal part resemble what? The straight part of the canal and the curved part of the canal. And what is the advantage of this technique? The main advantage of this technique, or the main purpose of this technique, is how to prepare the apical part safely when we ensure our file that preparing the apical part has no contact or stress on the coronal part. So first, we will determine the whole working length. And let's get the example, the working length is 22 millimeter. Then we will insert our file without patch winding. Just insert the file passively until it will stop from progressing to the apical. At this step, at this time, just measure the working length. The working length allow the file to go passively inside the canal. Let's say it's 16 millimeter. So the whole length of the canal is 22 millimeter, which was confirmed with the apex locator. And the straight part of the canal that allow the file to go passively, it is, for example, 16 millimeters. So we will name this part of the canal coronal zone, or the coronal part of the canal, the coronal zone. This coronal zone should be at first prepared. You should prepare it as you are preparing the whole canal. What does this mean? You will prepare it by using a super flexi file from Rogin, 15 table 6, 20 table 4, 25 table 6, 35 table 4. Then, of course, between each file, we will go, we'll use a patency file, irrigation, activation. Then, after we reach to the largest file, for example, 35 table 4, then we will go back again to file number 10. And now we will see how much the file number 10 will go to inside the canal. We will notice that the file will go more deeply, easily, and passively, and may reach the working length. Reach the working, it may not. But in the in any case, the whole length to measure it, will measure it. If you measure it, is the file goes to the 22 millimeter, which is the working length, then we will start the preparation of the apical zone by using 15 taper 5, 6, 20 taper 4, 25 taper 6, 35 taper 4. And in this time, our files is going to touch only the apical part. The rest of the file, especially in the coronal zone, will not be touched. And this is our main purpose. When we insert our file, we don't want our files to be touched at all its length. This this case will cause a file fracture because it will apply high stress on the file. So the apical zone, it will ensure safe preparation of the canal by dividing the canal into a coronal zone, which is a straight zone, or it is the part of the route that the canal allow the file to go passively. After preparing from A to Z to this zone, then we go again to prepare the rest of the canal, which is called apical zone. The another technique, which is called a taper technique, this technique the canal into three different parts. Each part will be prepared with a different taper of the file. So in this technique, we are placing, we're preparing the orifice by using a pre-flaring files or coronal pre-flaring files. And the coronal third, just the coronal third, we will prepare it by files, large taper files, taper 6, for example, and we don't prefer more than taper 6, as the studies shows that a literature review recommended that the maximum taper should be used in lower molars is with 25 taper 6, because more than taper 6 will cause more risk for perforation and zipping. And middle third of the canal will be should be prepared by using taper 4, and the last part of the canal, which as we know, the most narrowest part of the canal, the most complicated anatomy in the canal, should be prepared using a very small taper files, for example, taper 2. So playing with the taper to prepare the Kurtz canal safely by understanding the anatomy of the canal. As we know, it is a very large canal at the corner, and as much we goes to apical, it becomes more narrower, conical shape. So according to this anatomy, we apply our files and playing with the tapers. So large taper prepare the large part of the canal, small taper files prepare the small part of the canal. And this is an example of using a taper canals, taper technique. So the apical part is prepared as much as small as possible. This is an example. This is a case came to me to my clinic. For the patients here had a previous root canal treatment, and as you see, guys, the previous treatment had a broken file in the mesial root, and unfortunately, the dentist tried to bypass this file. He did a perforation, and he didn't notice that he did perforation. He thought